The question that I have is, what is the solution to Terzaghi's 1D consolidation equation? So let's talk about the solution to the differential equation. So just for convenience, I have repeated the equation here. This is the differential equation. This is the definition of the coefficient of consolidation, where u is a function of z and t. U is the excess for water pressure. So from your differential equations course, you know that to solve any differential equation, you need to have a set of boundary conditions, right? So this problem here is what we call a coupled problem, where u depends not only on the spatial coordinate z, but it also depends on time. And therefore, we need to have two types of condition. One type is called the boundary conditions, the other one is called the initial conditions. But there's only one initial condition here. Well, let's talk about the boundary conditions first. So to do that, I'm going to consider the doubly drained problem that we discussed earlier. A doubly drained problem, just to refresh your memory, is a problem where the clay layer is surrounded by two drainage boundary conditions, like in this case over here. So this drainage boundary could come from a sand layer over here, and similarly, if there is a sand layer here, this will make a drainage boundary. What does it mean? A drainage boundary cannot hold the excess pore water pressure. So the excess pore water pressure will remain to be zero at these boundaries. So for this problem, z equals zero, u is zero, z equals 2h, u is zero. In deriving the differential equation, I considered a problem where the soil deposit was subjected to a uniform vertical stress, right? And therefore, the increase in the vertical stress is constant throughout the layer. In such a problem, when T is zero, the excess pore water pressure is exactly equal to the applied vertical pressure. In other words, the excess pore water pressure is constant across the depth of the clay layer. But we know this is not always true. Supposing, say, I have a footing loading or something like that, we know the increase in vertical stress decreases with depth, right? And therefore, different kind of assumption for the initial condition would give you better results. But this is the sort of thing that you do in an advanced level course. And but here we are going to stick to this, and we are going to apply the solutions I'm going to show you in a second, even to a situation where the loading is applied through a footing. Here is the solution. So we have a series solution. A couple of things to note here. There is a counter, little m, that increases from 0 to infinity in the series. Number two, this u note here is the initial excess pore water pressure. And for our problem, that will be equal to delta sigma z. Then we have two key functions here. There is a sine function, there is an exponential function. The sine function is a function of z, and the exponential function is a function of little t, time. So to simplify the expression a little bit, we introduce another little counter here, big M, which is defined as this, and a second variable called the time factor. Time factor is defined as C sub V times little t over h squared. And it turns out this quantity, the time factor, is a dimensionless quantity. In terms of these two quantities, the solution now simplifies to a little bit. This u note is a constant for all of the terms in the series, and therefore that could be pulled out. And then in a functional form, the solution can be written like this. There is a function depending on the depth, or basically the depth over h, so that itself is a dimensionless quantity too, so you could call that as a dimensionless depth. And then there is a second function, which is a function of the time factor, which again is a dimensionless quantity. So this is a function of depth, this is a function of time. And also, we may want to note that as little t goes to infinity, big T, which is simply proportional to little t, also goes to infinity. So when t sub v goes to infinity, this exponential term goes to zero, and therefore little u goes to zero, as it should be. In other words, excess pore water pressure dissipates completely when the time is very large. Also, it's very easy to see that the solution satisfies the boundary condition in that when z equals zero, we know the sine function is zero, and therefore the excess pore water pressure is zero, right? So on this drainage boundary, the excess pore water pressure is zero. And similarly, if I put z equals 2h, it can be easily shown that this function again is zero, and therefore the excess pore pressure is zero at the bottom drainage boundary.